Welcome to our guide on piping expansion loops. We'll discuss the technical details of this important component and empower engineers with the knowledge to design effective expansion loops. We'll provide expert tips and tricks based on industry experience to optimize the performance of expansion loops. Join us as we explore the expansion loops and enhance your understanding of piping systems. It is important to perform a flexibility check on the lines situated on long pipe racks, especially for pipes that transport fluids with high temperatures. These lines tend to cause excessive expansion at the end of the pipe racks. To prevent or control this expansion, a line stop is essential at the center of the line or the native zero point of the line where the expansion is zero. After that, you need to inspect the expansion distance at the end of the pipe racks. If the expansion at the far end of the pipe rack is enough to handle, the length of the pipe shoe should be kept longer to accommodate thermal expansion growth. However, if the expansion is too long, you should consider a design that includes an expansion loop. Also, it's important to take into account the flexibility of the branch connections, especially at the far end of the racks. If the main line's expansion is high, you may need to reconsider the branch connection design to make it more flexible or install an expansion loop. If you have multiple branch connections, this could end up being quite costly for you. It is preferable to use an expansion loop on the main line instead. In some cases, you can consider using an expansion loop to account for occasional forces, especially seismic loads. In case the seismic loads on the stopper support are high, we can divide the load by using an expansion loop on the rack. When designing an expansion loop, consider all the lines that require an expansion loop should be located close to each other. The largest expansion loop must be located outside the other loops with less growth. This equation can be used to determine the size of the expansion loop. In this example, the pipe diameter of the line is 24 inches, the length is 42 meters. The operating temperature of the line is 343 degrees Celsius and the ambient temperature is minus 17 degrees Celsius. Let's find the height and width of the expansion loop. Once we put the figures in the formula, we will figure out that the height is 9.1 meters and the width is 13.7 meters. Comparing the existing length with the calculated expansion loop sizes, we can see that the height is too long. Preferably, the height value should be a bit longer than the pipe rack width. So, we should add one more expansion loop to reduce the height of the loop. This means that the length between the anchors will be reduced to half. Let's see though the width of the reduced height is suitable for a 6-meter wide pipe rack. We will consider that the length between the anchor points is reduced to half, which is 21 meters. By applying the change in the formula, the height is 6.5 meters and the maximum width is 9.7 meters. In this case, adding two expansion loops will suffice for a 6-meter wide pipe rack, otherwise, we would need additional structure to support the expansion loop, which would be costly in terms of construction. In summary, before we decide on an expansion loop, we should inspect the pipe rack ends to see the level of expansion. An expansion loop can only be considered if expansion at the end of the rack is uneconomical to eliminate. The piping expansion loop design should be considered together with the nearby lines. Finally, the expansion loop size should not be so long, try to keep it inside the rack. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to pipingstress.net, hit the like button, and turn on the notifications for the next videos.